I've spent a lot of this year listening to politicians on their way to Washington trumpeting the values of American exceptionalism. Yet you use terms like, let's see, it was very, you use terms like mantle of mediocrity, that the world was passing us by. You are very blunt in describing our deficiencies. How does that square with Americans' desire to think of themselves as exceptional?
I think it's my job to tell the truth. And whether you look at these recent PISA results, which we are mediocre at best, whether you look at a 25% dropout rate in this country, whether you look at in one generation that we've fallen from first to ninth in the world in college graduates, by any measure, we're not doing what we need to be doing to keep America great. And I'm just absolutely convinced we have to educate our way to a better economy. That's the only way we're going to get there. This is the best long-term investment we can make. And so I think it's my job to be the truth teller. And the only way we get better is to look in the mirror, assess our strengths and weaknesses, and figure out where we need to go. But if we run around saying we're number one, and we're not, that doesn't help us get where we need to go.
By 2018, I know you know this, America is going to need 22 million educated workers. It's on the trajectory to be 3 million workers short of that number.
Yes.
How do you begin to close that gap? And explain a little bit more fully also for the people in the room and the people online and people watching exactly how we got to this point where so many people are going to college and so few are leaving college with a degree.
Well, let me take it even back a step further from that. So if the goal is to dramatically improve college completion rates, not college going rates
right.
by itself, but college completion, it's not just a college problem. I'll get there. You have to, again, in all these things, look at the whole continuum. So we need a big focus on early childhood education. There's lots of data in the OECD study that our early childhood education system is pretty good in this country. Not enough students have opportunity, and very discouragingly, they lose their advantage because they go to poor schools after that. So let's focus on our babies. Secondly, we've had this massive effort on K-12 reform, raising standards, great teachers, great principals, turning around chronically failing schools, raising the bar, huge amount of progress, let's continue that. Finally, we have to build a culture around college completion at the higher education, both at four-year and two-year institutions. To tell you exactly what we're doing, we're going to every single state, we're looking at every single four-year and two-year school in those states, we're telling them what their graduation rates are now, and to hit the president's goal, how much each of those universities has to contribute in terms of improving outcomes, improving graduation rates. So every school, every state will have a clear trajectory of where they need to go, and we're gonna monitor their progress, see which states are doing a great job, which aren't. But this one is a very practical, we know, we can tell every single institution of higher education what they need to do to contribute. I just wanna say that they can't do it alone. We have to fix the pipeline. So a huge amount of work has to be to increase the quality of student going into higher education. Far too many of our children today, our students need remedial education. We've been lying to them. They're not really ready for college. That's not higher education's fault. That's our fault, K-12.